Some disturbing reports about debt and poverty in the United States, mission accomplished in Iraq, and are Occupy Wall Street protesters endangering the lives of New Yorkers?
Oh yeah.
Hey guys, it's October 24th, 2011. My name is Reginald, I'm also known as Dimcat. First, mission accomplished. After hundreds of thousands of Iraqi civilians have been killed and 4,400 American soldiers have been killed and many more injured, we're finally going to pull out of Iraq, mainly because we're being kicked out by their government. Their government is more of a Shiite government, more of a pro-Iranian government than the last government. They also support the president of Syria. They want their own nuclear program for nuclear reactors, and they also support Iran's nuclear program. So what was all that rhetoric about, weapons of mass destruction, and Saddam was linked to Al-Qaeda and all this nonsense before the war? Well, look, Saddam was about to sell his oil in euros, and that threatened the supremacy of the US dollar, the petrodollar, because right now you have to sell your oil exclusively in US dollars, and that's one of the reasons why the US dollar is the world's reserve currency. Saddam threatened that, so I think that's the reason why they had to get rid of his ass. Gaddafi also threatened that by trying to unite African countries to sell their oil in gold-backed assets. You saw what happened to him. They actually shared a similar fate. That's what I think really went down there. But anyway, mission accomplished, right? I'm glad that we're finally getting our people out of there, because our people don't need to die over somebody else's greed. Okay, the number of people shot in New York in the last 2 weeks has increased 154%. And this New York Post article is trying to tie Occupy Wall Street protesters to this. They're saying, essentially people in New York City are saying that because the police are dedicating 3,000 cops to these non-violent protests, that's taking away cops from other areas in the city and making the city less safe. First of all, whose decision was it to take 3,000 cops and use them on non-violent protesters? That's idiotic. Okay, they should be focusing less on protecting bankers and more on protecting the actual people of the city, because there's not really any violence going down at Occupy Wall Street. The only violence that's being introduced is the violence introduced by some police officers. I mean, that's the truth right there. Yes, crime is going up. Yes, shooting is going up. But what the article didn't point out is that shootings have been going up in New York City long before this. I actually found an article going back to Labor Day this year. Two cops were shot among the 67 people who were shot on Labor Day weekend. 67 people, okay? I'm talking, 10 on Saturday, 33 on Sunday, 15 on Monday. These type of numbers, okay? 10 people were killed. Those were the preliminary numbers right there. All this, and even in 2010, when you look at 2010, homicides were up 22% in the earlier part of 2010 compared to the earlier part of the year of 2009. The city's shootings increased by 14%. So obviously New York has been experiencing more and more crimes long before Occupy Wall Street. Okay, so please don't try to blame them for this violence. It makes absolutely no sense, and the facts obviously don't back up this theory, this correlation that people are trying to draw up. What's interesting is that I thought New York City was supposed to be so safe, and you know, it's pretty much impossible for people to bring guns into New York City, right? Well, they have really strict gun laws that restrict the rights of law-abiding citizens, so they can't bring guns into New York City, but obviously the criminals aren't having a problem doing that at all. Nearby Rhode Island, they're tackling pensions, and by tackling, I mean their pension fund is underfunded. They have a pension liability estimated at $7 billion. This is up 47% from $4.7 billion in 2009. Holy crap! According to Pew Center on the states, what they're going to try to do is change the pension plans, break them up. They're going to create a hybrid plan that has some traditional elements, but it also wants to sharply reduce the pension guarantees with a 401k type of style adjustment. They also want to get rid of cost of living adjustments, and well, you get the picture. Basically, going down the road that George Carlin was talking about in American Dream. They're going to get your pension, your Social Security, all that. Yes, pretty much that. Student loan bubble to exceed $1 trillion. $1 trillion. So we have more people with more college degrees, but they can't actually find decent jobs. Okay, student borrowing has actually doubled in the last decade. And it's basically slavery. That's what it is. You work your ass off to get into college, you get this degree, and not all these degrees are useless. A lot of these degrees are actually in science and something that's marketable, but the jobs aren't actually there. And they graduate from college and, well, they're making $10 an hour, but they owe, what, $50,000, $60,000 in debt? I mean, are you kidding me? Peanut butter, the cost of peanut butter. This is a October 10th article. The cost of peanut butter is going to increase. Jif is going up 30% starting in November, and Peter Pan will increase 24% in the next couple of weeks, which will probably be about now. Probably thinking, well, what does this story have to do with everything else? The cost of food going up. If you like peanut butter, you better get your peanut butter now. Speaking of food, the amount of people on food stamps in June 2011 was 45.1 million. Well, actually, it's 45.1 8 million, and it increased to 45,344,946 in July of this year. There was a little decrease in one of those months, but then it kept going back up. That's a sign of the times. Another sign of the times. In LA, the LA Health Clinic, they had a 4-day event in which they brought in CareNow, which they wanted to treat 5,000 uninsured or underinsured patients and give them free dental care. Meanwhile, General Electric, the same company that didn't have to pay any taxes in 2010, right? their profits went up 57%. Now, a lot of that had to do with the Comcast deal, NBC Universal Comcast deal, but they're obviously doing really, really well, and well... It's amazing how certain people get certain rights and, well, certain entities get treated better than actual human beings. But hey, they're making money, right? There's nothing wrong with making money. It's just sometimes I have a problem with the way that certain entities make money. But anyway, America surpasses 100% debt to GDP on Halloween. Yeah. Insert bad joke. it's not funny, but it's... What else can I say? Alright, guys. Tell me what you think. Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. Or those who run out and get their peanut butter today. Bye.